Do you need flood insurance if you live in Florida? Let's take a look at that. Just in case you didn't know it, the state of Florida is actually a peninsula surrounded by waters on all but one side of the state. However, that doesn't mean that the entire state is at risk of constant flooding. Just like the rest of the country, the requirement to carry flood insurance for a property is based off that property's elevation above the base flood elevation, which is determined by FEMA, the Federal Emergency Management Association, and that information can be found on their FERM maps, which stands for Flood Insurance Rate Maps. Based off the information contained in these FERM maps, your home is issued a flood zone designation code. The main codes that we deal with for flood zone classification are V, VE, A, AE, and X. The V zones carry the highest risk of flooding and therefore the highest flood insurance premium for a property. These are typically properties that are located directly on the coast, facing out into the intercoastal or the Gulf of Mexico in the case that you're in the Tampa Bay area here. Not only do properties in the V zones carry a greater risk of flooding, they also have a greater risk of wave action or storm surge if there were to be a large storm. Like properties located in the V flood zones, the A flood zone properties also typically require flood insurance. These properties are also located in an area that is determined to be at higher risk of flooding. And what that means is properties that are in an A or an AE zone are typically considered to be within the 100-year floodplain, meaning you've got about a 1% chance on average of the property flooding each year. And FEMA has determined that there's a high degree of certainty that over the course of a 100-year period, the property will flood at least once. That doesn't mean that the property is guaranteed to flood, but you are at higher risk if you are in an A zone. However, the A zones do not carry the same risk of wave action or storm surge that properties located in the V zones carry. Next up after the A zones is the X500 zone. Now this one's a little bit different because the X500 zone is considered to be a property that is located in the 500-year floodplain, meaning it's likely that the property will flood at least once over the course of 500 years. For most of us, we probably don't have to worry about that too much. After the X500 zone comes the X flood zone designation. Properties that are located in an X zone are considered to be outside of the 100-year and the 500-year floodplain. One other thing that is important to note with flood zones is a property can actually have more than one flood zone designation, depending upon the elevation of the lot. For example, my personal home is located in both an X zone and an A zone because part of the property sits lower and part of the property sits higher. So when is flood insurance actually required? For homes with a mortgage, your lender requires that flood insurance be carried on the property if you're located in any of the V zones or any of the A zones. And I have occasionally seen a lender require flood insurance for a home that is located in an X500 zone, although that is not the norm. If your property is located in an X flood zone, great news, you're not required to carry flood insurance, regardless of whether or not you have a mortgage on the property. However, it really doesn't matter which zone you're in because it's always a good idea to consider getting flood insurance on your property because most homeowners insurance policies will not cover water damage from flooding. Also, if you are in a lower risk zone or an X zone that does not require flood insurance, the flood insurance premium is going to be much lower than it would be for a property that was located in an A zone or a V zone where flood insurance may be required. Also, according to FEMA, 25% of flood claims occur on low-risk properties, such as homes that are located in an X flood zone and don't require flood insurance. So, no matter what, it's a good idea to consider getting flood insurance for your property, even if it's not required. So there you have it. That's a quick rundown of the different flood zone classification codes that your property will fall into and how that determines whether or not you are required to carry flood insurance for your property. Well, that's going to do it for this week. Thank you very much for watching all the way to the end here. If you haven't yet, click the subscribe button down below, click the notification bell so that you get notified every time I publish a new video. click the thumbs up and like this video if you did. Leave me a comment down below if you've got something to add, and please reach out to me today if you have any real estate questions. My contact information is down below in the description of this video. Thank you again, and see you next week.